So guys, here's the session for Shayad, and as you can see, the project is not very well organized, but I've tried to organize just for the session as much as I could. I'll play some snippets of the song so that you guys can get an idea how the session sounds like. So this is my session for Shayad, and as you can see, like, it doesn't have a few elements, like the instruments that were recorded live, as this was a session that I passed on to Arijit, and then he dubbed all the real instruments and made some production changes as well. So this is my session for the song, and before I started the production of the song, I received a demo production as well as demo vocals from Pritam da. And I didn't use anything from the production, I just used the demo vocals from it, and this is how the vocals sound like.
ये कुछ तुमसे ज़्यादा तुमसे कम नहीं जो तुम ना हो तो हम भी हम नहीं जो तुम ना हो तो हम भी हम नहीं ना चाहिए कुछ तुमसे ज्यादा तुमसे कम नहीं.
So let's start with the breakdown of the song element by element. So what I do is I always start any production with the chords first. I lay down the chords throughout the song and then I start adding elements like drums, FXs and other production elements. So I started with this plug patch and recorded some chords over it, and it sounds something like this. After laying down the chords, I started arranging the FXs. FXs for me, especially textures, are very important for any production that I do. And I feel like FXs add space, ambience and soul to the track. Like certain FXs like vinyl sounds and adding like little nature elements, say like a reverb sample, that is very low in the levels. But even if you can't hear it directly, it for sure adds a certain vibe to the whole song. These special effects that I use sound something like these. Then there are other effects like some drone samples as well, and they sound something like this. The final flute was dubbed later, but I also added like a few flute one shots, and they sound something like this. Now I'll play the song with and without the FXs so that you guys can get an idea how much of an impact the FXs create in the song. So this is without the FXs. And this is with the effects turned on. So let's move on to the next element of the song, and that is drums. The drums in the chorus section sound something like this. As you can hear, it's not a very complex drum pattern. I think the song also didn't need much complexity in it. But there are certain small details that add to the production a lot. So there's this filtered percussion. There's this clock sample going on as well. And that also runs basically throughout the song. And then there are a few fills here and there as well. This is a tom fill, I guess. And this is the main kick for the song. As you can hear in the song, the build-up transition is pretty smooth, and that was only possible because of certain samples in the drum section. One of them sounds like this. Then there are build-up claps going on as well. They sound like this. All these small samples helped in smoothing out the build-up transition to the chorus. So let's move on to the next element, and that is the bass loop. So let's move on to the next section, and this is the drop chord section. This is basically the soul for the whole chorus. I'll play this section with and without the drop chords, and you guys can totally figure out like what I mean. So this is without the drop chords. And this is with the drop chords on. So as you guys can see, this is a pretty big stack and it involves quite a lot of layers. So I'll go with the whole stack layer by layer. The first is a pad. The second one is a fake PRS guitar that was an Omnisphere patch, and it sounds something like this. Then I added a contact library that sounds like a choir and sounds something like this. The next patch is a sample from an old Yamaha vintage keyboard and it sounds something like this. And the last one is the main sound of the stack, and it's a pure saw wave. As you guys can see, all of my tracks are frozen. The only reason behind this is my laptop can't handle all the processing while recording everything in 4K. Coming back to the effects part, like we talked earlier, the effects are a very essential part of the whole production. In the drop also, they play a very important role. So I'll quickly mute and unmute the effects section in the drop, and you guys can hear the difference yourself. So this is without the effects. And this is with the effects turned on. So basically, this was my involvement in the production of the song. After I made the session, I forwarded the stems and the session as well to Arijit, Sunny, and Zafar. They did the live dubbings and did all the like final touches and polishing of the production and stuff. And that is the version that you hear in the movie as well.